The 30 players who were drawn from different secondary schools in the country were recruited last year from the 157 players who were turned out for the selection process that was held at James Cambridge International School. The players will benefit from a 5-day training that is led by Southampton's lead youth development phase coach Daniel Maye and academy goalkeeping coach Simon James Locke, among others.
What we look to do is to break down the sessions into strength and conditioning. We have a physio on site for any mishaps or any injuries that we may have. But our global development manager is to work with the Kenyan Federation coaches and just work with them and try and impart a little bit of knowledge of what we're trying to achieve from the sessions.
Sportpesa is playing its role in ensuring proper coaching programs are put in place as we build a proud national team that will not only qualify for the World Cup in 2022, but also make a great impact.
The 30 players are drawn from Bandari Youth, Savannah FC, Kakamega High School, Lesa Hill, Jamhuri High, among others.
We're in a position to get a good team for the under-17. You realize Kenya has not featured in a long time in any under-17 competition. So we hope that with this camp, we'll be able to now have an under-17 whereby we'll have a graduation process where they go to under-19, under-20, under-23, then eventually to the top tier league.
Southampton, Sportpesa, FKF and KPL will later unveil a final squad that will make up a Kenyan team that will participate in a possible World Cup in 2022. Sportpesa and Southampton signed a 3-year partnership in 2016. Frederick Muki for Channel 1 Sports.